Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of CNB Bazaar Buzz here on the NDTV network. I am Cyrus Behram-Dabur and here's what we have in store for you on the show today. New launches, the Mahindra Marazzo and the Tata Tiago NRG. Mercedes' first electric SUV. It's the festive season coming up, and that means a whole bunch of launches coming up too. Tata Motors and Mahindra have already sort of gotten the ball rolling with their new cars. Here's both of them, have a look.
Two big launches from the Desi car makers that get our attention for sure. Tata Motors has introduced the new Tiago NRG crossover, and Mahindra has brought us the shark-inspired Marazzo. Tata's newest is based on the standard Tiago hatch. The Tiago NRG is the second launch from Tata for this festive season after the Nexon Kraz, and the company has two more products lined up.
To the Tiago brand, which is the best-selling brand of Tata Motors and has actually turned the needle in 2016 as far as our passenger vehicle business is concerned. Yeah. Right on time for the festive season, it's one out of four launches. One is just performed a week ago. Two more very exciting launches can be expected. And then we will continue our firework of new launches right after the festive season in preparation of the next one.
So what is the Tiago NRG all about?
Well, additional roof rails, body cladding, and a higher ground clearance of 180 mm. That's what the changes are on this urban tough road, as Tata calls it. And that's what we're here to check out.
The Tiago NRG is longer, wider, and taller than the standard hatchback, thanks to the body cladding that extends to the bumpers, doors, and the wheel arches. A four skid plate has been added to the rear bumper for a rugged look. While the grille and the outside rearview mirrors have been blacked out, there's additional black cladding on the tailgate that carries the NRG badge. The roof is finished in black for a dual tone effect, and the car also comes with a larger roof mounted spoiler. The Tiago NRG rides on 14-inch alloy wheels that look funky, and the ground clearance has increased by 10mm. The cabin gets limited changes, retaining the same layout as the Tiago, and features orange accents on the AC vents and around the gear shift lever. While the fabric upholstered seats get orange contrast stitching, the big update is the inclusion of a 5-inch touchscreen infotainment system that supports voice commands, smartphone connectivity, and navigation with 3D maps. The Tiago NRG also comes with a 4-speaker Harman audio system. It also gets dual front airbags, ABS with EBD, and corner stability control as part of the standard kit. The engine lineup remains the same as the hatch, but there is no AMT or automatic on the NRG. The car is priced at 5.5 lakh rupees for the petrol version and 6 lakh 32,000 for the diesel version. And you get the choice of three colors. Now on to M&M. Mahindra has launched the much-anticipated Marazzo MPV in India at an introductory price of 9,99,000 to 13,90,000 rupees. The MPV has been positioned just below the XUV 500 in Mahindra's lineup.
So the Mahindra Marazzo is finally here, and it's aiming not just at the Toyota Innova or the Maruti Suzuki Ertiga as we all had imagined at the start. Instead, what it's trying to do is to take this sort of an appeal of a family vehicle into a slightly different zone. So it does offer a little more premiumness, a little more luxury than what typically MPVs offer, which means you try and attract the well-heeled family audience as well. Also, from a fleet perspective, only the top end of the fleet market, not really the cab aggregators or the taxis at the low end of that. And then, of course, that also means that you're taking away, or hoping to at least take away, some of the buyers of the sedan segment that sits between about 8 and 15 lakh rupees. So Mahindra has thrown down the gauntlet. Now, of course, the proof would be in seeing just whether the customers pick it up or not.
The Marazzo's design has been inspired by the shark. Mahindra has tried to mimic the Predator's key characteristics with some visual traits like the large eye-shaped projector headlamps, chrome-tooth grille, bold 17-inch alloy wheels, optional shark fin antenna and the shark tail-like LED tail lamps. The Marazzo is based on an all-new platform, which uses a body-on-frame chassis with front-wheel drive, and Mahindra has invested a total of $200 million in the U321 project. The MPV is offered in both 7-seater and 8-seater layouts, featuring off-white interior with a dual-tone glassy black dashboard. Features include a touchscreen infotainment system, leatherette upholstery, and an industry-first surround cool technology, among others.
So why this huge investment in an MPV and not in a flagship SUV product? Well, that's because it points to what will come from Mahindra. It's a new platform, one that can wear different top hats and will. And I can tell you there's one particular product that will definitely come on this platform, but let me not go there. New engine that will certainly come on the very next product, which is the S201 that we know will launch in just a few months' time, the subcompact SUV that's coming. Same 1.5 liter engine goes in there. And of course, then you have the new layout, which is a world first. All of that points to what's coming from Mahindra in terms of sophistication of design, engineering and capability. It is, therefore, that big turnaround product that we've been waiting for from this car maker.
The Marazzo just gets a new diesel hot for now. Mated to a 6-speed manual gearbox. The petrol engine and an automatic option will be introduced along with the BS6 version expected in 2020. With its prices, the Marazzo undercuts both its key rivals, the Toyota Innova Crysta and the Tata Hexa. The Maruti Suzuki Ertiga remains the most affordable MPV for now, but a new Ertiga is expected in November this year. So there will be good times ahead for the MPV space.
Huge day for Mahindra with the launch of the Marazzo. Marazzo, I've got it right now, Pawan, thank you. And many, many congratulations. Dr. Pawan Goenka, of course, is the man helming everything here today. But I see that the entire team, the focus that we find on this car, there is a huge difference between prior products and this one in so many ways. But first things first, you know, so much said today about this becoming a milestone product for Mahindra. Why is it so?
Well, milestone because of many things. Okay. First of all, the architecture itself. Something that has never been done in the world in a production vehicle. Prototypes have been done, but not production. Having an east-west engine on a ladder frame vehicle. That almost is the perfect solution of taking out the negatives of ladder frame and yet maintain the positives of the ruggedness of durability that one likes to buy ladder frame for. We have also been able to take care of the seating of the stepping height, which is again negative of ladder frame. So I would therefore consider it to be best of both worlds product in terms of combining what's good for front wheel drive and what's good off ladder frame. That's one. Second is the way we have done this whole product, which almost becomes a template for future of using our engineers that we have in Mana in Detroit and using our engineers and infrastructure that we have in MRV in Chennai, working together to do from architecture, initial engineering, prototyping, tooling, sourcing, and bringing it all together. In the first phase, when the epicenter of the work was in Detroit, we had at any given point of time 25-30 engineers from MRV residing there, so much so that we bought an apartment building to house those people.
Okay.
And then in the later part, when action shifted to a plant here in Nasik and to MRV in Chennai, a lot of the Mana engineers came here. Constant video conferences between them, thanks to all the connectivity and low cost of connectivity now, almost every day interaction with them. So that sort of sets a new template of how we will develop future product. And then Pininfarina and our own design team. Okay. And for any new product that we're doing now, we are sort of having a Pininfarina design and a Mahindra design studio design and then coming together and again picking best of both to do the final design. So here you will see that, I hope you'll agree with me, that's not a boring MPV that one think of. So much so that we decided not to call it MPV because most people told us it's not MPV. And you look at interior, the premiumness, the plushness that we have built into this product at 9.99 lakh is something that is where it's now knowing that how much you care for safety. I want to specifically talk about safety. Safety, of course, I don't need to tell you, has two aspects, what you built in and what you protect afterwards. We have really gone out of our way in terms of safety that we built into this product. 52% high strength steel. I don't think you will find a car in this category with 52% high strength steel today anywhere. Then using our whole structural design in a way that even though this vehicle does not have to meet side crash, we are meeting side crash. Already have the certificate. Not the certificate where you cannot get it, but have the test
ready. Yeah.
Rear impact. Not required for this class of vehicle, we are meeting rear impact. Crash, of course, we have to meet. Then PED Pro. Not yet required for this yet in India, but we're meeting PED Pro. So everything that we can think of, we have done in terms of building in safety into the vehicle. Of course, disc brake, all disc brake, again, something not very common in this segment. We have done that too. And then starting off with the two airbags that we have clearly, and ISOFIX seat for child safety. And obviously, we will go for global certification of safety, which we'll do in some time.
All right, so much packed into it. So how much of a challenge then was it to arrive at this very attractive pricing, because it's been under an hour now, but already the reactions are coming thick and fast. People like the price.
Yes, of course.
How tough was it to get to that number?
Well, again, one would think that our product engineered in Detroit, you would not have the frugality that one typically thinks of a product engineered in India. Yeah. But this is again talking about best of both worlds. Okay, we had people here sitting in Kandivali, sitting in Chennai, who are controlling in a sense that you cannot go above a certain point, right? And I think we managed to do
a pretty good
job of bringing things in. I mean, like a simple thing of that, sliding opening for the
cup holders.
Not cup holder. It's called, you have this flexible sliding thing.
Very
expensive.
Rest.
Very expensive. And our team wanted to put it because it'll be unique, but then we had to really struggle hard to get the price right. So I think you just have to do it bit by bit, piece by piece, and for everything without compromising with the value that you want to create. To get the price point right is always challenging.
Well, I mean, the initial reaction is a great one. So wish you all the best with that
Thank
plan.
You.
Thank you. Thanks for your time. Congrats again.